Next.
Swami ji, what is the value and meaning of relationship? Should we give up relationships? Is that what you are saying?
It's a beautiful question. You are not supposed to give up the relationships. You are supposed to give up the expectations in relationship. I always tell people, renounce what you don't have. You don't have to renounce what you have. Live happily with your wife. Just renounce the fantasies you have about your wife. Live happily, intensely with your spouse. Drop the fantasies which you have about your spouse. Next session is about that only.
In day-to-day lives, we often come across negative energy. Though we're not astute enough to know, but sometimes we come home and find that, you know, in spite of the house, having everything that one would need, instead of happiness, there is irritation, there is anger, there is a kind of tension in the air. Typically, it happens with everybody's overworked. But how then we convert this negative energy to positive energy?
Immediately, just go for a bath. Take bath and sit and meditate. Do at least one meditation. The whole energy will be changed. I understand what you are saying. I understand the situation. This is the best solution.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's nice to turn the positive energies and the reality is,
there's just so much of angers and haters and one-offs out in the world, and you know, just you know, like to share your thoughts on how you personally see the world with all this.
How I personally see the world. According to me, the world is running perfectly, beautifully, as it should be. The maximum positive way it is running. You can't develop anything more. God has done perfect job. We always think that the job is given to us, we will be doing much better job. But anyway, I am not able to think that I am doing much better job than God. So what is perfectly all right. If at all something has to be changed, it is us. Inside, nothing outside. The same existence energy. Who has created the whole thing? Any one religion, take it up properly and do intensely, you will realize God. That's all. You see, difference is only in your intensity. There is no difference in the path. Go intensely, any one religion is enough. The difference is only in intensity, not in the path. Any path is okay. Go intensely, that's all. Intensity is what is what you need. Yes, you are growing much faster way to the same path.
From what I understood reading, religion kind of divided into two camps. One believe in one God concept, that means the creator. This creator decides, you know, how the earth and everything else, you know, stated in some of the religion book. The other will be the God's concept. And so I have two questions. What do you think about this kind of two camps concept? And the second question, you referring to this energy that you were talking about. The God, as you explained earlier on, is energy. So does this belong to which camp? Is it a creator or what?
You are asking about this single God and many gods theory. Please understand. God is energy. The energy, you can't say energy is one or many. It is energy. Forms can be many. The many forms also is a technique to make you experience that energy. Saying there is only one form also is a technique to make you realize that energy. If they say only one form, you will concentrate on that and realize that energy. If they say many form, whatever form you like, you can concentrate and realize that energy. See, when you say there is only one form, there is a very big danger. If you don't like that form, you will stop going to religion. In Hinduism, at least 86% people go to temples. With many forms, you have a choice. You have your own choice. And the life becomes more juicy. Life becomes more juicy when you have choice. In the spiritual world, we had a choice. West, outer world enough choice, inner world no choice. In the East, inner world you have choice, outer world no choice. That's the difference. So better to have choice in the inner world than in the outer world.
Morning. Can you explain a spiritual enlightenment?
Having direct heartline connection with the cosmic energy is what I call enlightenment. There is an energy which runs the whole world, whole universe. Experiencing that energy only is running your body. That energy only is running your mind. That energy only is running your being is what I call enlightenment. If you think you are running, you have ego. If you think no, Parashakti is running, the existence is running, the energy is running, cosmic energy is running, then you become enlightened. That's all. Realizing the Dhamma of the cosmos is only Dhamma of the macrocosm is same as Dhamma of the microcosm is enlightenment. Realizing the Dhamma of the microcosm and Dhamma of the macrocosm is one and the same. Macrocosm is universe. Microcosm is this body. The Dhamma behind both is one and the same. If you experience that, you are enlightened. Yes. Dhamma means, I mean Dharma.
Spiritual.
Well, when we, the cosmic energy which joins and enters us, and when it leaves us, what's that process like? What actually happens in our body?
Oh, it's a huge question. You are asking the secret of death and birth. I think you have to do the next course, the NSP. NSP is all about birth and death. So, it takes 4 days for me to explain what happens at the time of death. So only the next course can explain. Now I don't think I will be able to answer such a big question. If I answer in a short way, I will not feel satisfied.
Okay, next.
You mentioned about how people's bodies are made to be vegetarian. But many people eat meat and live to be 100 years old, and they set world records and they live.
Please understand. It is not that because of meat they lived 100 years. In spite of meat they lived 100 years. If they have taken vegetarian food, they would have lived 200 years. I say one thing. You can't speak only based on this one information. You have to see, the vegetarian guys, they must have been doing many other wrong things to reduce their life. That can be the reason for why they are living short life. The non-vegetarian guys, they may be doing many other good things to extend their life. One thing I can be sure, vegetarianism is one of the wonderful best strategy for your good health. That is not the only way, that's the one main way. The people who are having non-veg, they may be doing many other, so many other good things to keep their health, to make them live 100 years. If they would have been vegetarian with all the other good habits, they would have lived 200 years. And if these vegetarian guys, they must have doing many other bad things, spoiling their health, worrying, unnecessarily bothering, all those things. If these guys would have been non-vegetarian, they would have died 10 years before. So vegetarianism is one of the best method for living long. That doesn't mean only by that you can do anything. No. It's one of the technique, one of the method. If you take the common statistics, there are so many statistics which proves really the vegetarians live a long time. There are always exemptions. See, non-vegetarian living long time is not a rule, it's an exemption. Vegetarian dying earlier is not a rule, it's an exemption. Exemption shows that there is something else called rule. The very exemption proves rule is different. So what you are speaking is exemption. That itself is a proof that rule is something else. That's all. I can give you that, you can see that website, Reversing the Heart Disease.
Yeah, we.
That doctor has done a very big statistics research.
But I personally feel that in order to look at health alone, it's very difficult to be a vegetarian, very frankly speaking, because there are a lot of people not vegetarian, and yet they live a healthy life. So the thing is, I realize that you have to have very much compassion for animals, for you to sustain. And that's something that worries me when we talk about energy, because we tend to classify animals as a lower energy. It tends to be this superior, you know, kind of a concept
thing,
about
one
and,
thing.
And when you think that they are lower energy, you tend to look down on them. You know, that's sort of like propagate the whole thing about animals. Often you can eat them, it's no issue, it's no problem.
Let me tell you one thing. When you kill them, they release so much of agony and pain in their body. All that negativity will be stored in their body. If you eat that same body, what will happen to your system? When you kill animals, they release so much of agony, pain, suffering into your system. If somebody eats that body, the same energy will enter into that person. He will be prone to depression. There are so many reasonings we can give. I am trying to give whatever reasons I know, that's all. This Vishwanatha and Vishwarupa, all these things are too much of intellectual knowledge. You see, too much reading, too much of ideas without meditative experience is nothing like, it's nothing but eating cow dung. Don't eat cow dung. Don't eat too much of these big words. It will be dangerous for you. Understand, when you meditate, you experience Vishwanatha and Vishwarupa. But if you know already the word Vishwanatha and Vishwarupa, before experience you will start visualizing, imagining. You are in a danger of imagining all those things if you learn about all these things before experience. You understand what I say? So never learn these big words. Don't learn these big words before experience, because you will start imagining it. Better work for experience, let it happen. Let you not visualize. Me? No. No. Strict no. People ask me, Swamiji, once in a while can I take non-vegetarian? Then you are non-vegetarian, how can you call yourself as vegetarian? One guy came and told me, Swamiji, I am fasting except 3 times a day. I am fasting except 3 times a day. Only the 3 times I eat, otherwise I am fasting. So how can you say, I am fasting except 2 times a day. I am a non-vegetarian except once in a week. How can you say that? No. No animal products.
She is asking whether you could take fish oil supplement.
No. Including medicines which contains animal products should not be taken. According to me, I go to the extent of that vegetarianism. There are so many Ayurvedic products, Ayurvedic medicines which doesn't have animal products. Use that if you are really compassionate and if you are really. And one more thing. What are you going to do by living so long, eating all the animals in the planet Earth? Why should you live at all so long? All right, in that case, if somebody suddenly discovers, if you eat human meat, you will live for a long time. You will start eating. If you eat human meat, you will live for 300 years. If somebody discovers, what you will do? Then you will start eating human meat for the sake of 200 years, 300 years. No. Live as long as you can eat vegetarian things and live. When you can't, then live gracefully. That's all. What's wrong in it? We lived beautifully. Let's say goodbye gracefully. One thing, add quality to your life, not quantity. Don't work to add years to your life. Add life to your years. Adding years to your life is not an important thing. Adding life to your years is the important thing. Add life to your years. Naturally, you will not bother about living.